Are you using Adobe Premiere CC or thinking of subscribing to the Adobe Suite? Well, give me a few minutes and I'm going to tell you why you shouldn't do it, why you should save your money, and best of all, I'm going to show you what the alternative is, and it's free. Stay tuned because we're starting right now. So I just started my YouTube channel not long ago. The channel is in diapers, yeah? I hardly have any subscribers. I just uploaded 3 videos up till now. And lo and behold, I started having problems with Adobe Premiere. It constantly crashed like a mofo. It was so annoying and so frustrating. I didn't know what to do anymore. So what do you do when you're having problems with your software? You go to YouTube, you go to forums, you go to tech support. I spent hours trying to figure out why Adobe is constantly crashing. It was so frustrating. I ended up spending probably almost a week, like 5 days, a few hours each day with Adobe tech support. They tried to figure out, couldn't figure out what the problem was. It was just a nightmare. Threw off the whole momentum of me shooting and, you know, uploading. So Adobe technicians could not figure out what the problem was, could not help me, and I'm stuck with a software that I'm paying monthly for that's not working. So annoying. But what happened was, after I got tired of dealing with tech support, they couldn't figure out what the problem was. The good thing that came out of this whole mess is that I started looking at alternative for Adobe Premiere. And the more I researched, the more I went on YouTube and checked out some videos, what other editors or filmmakers think of Adobe Premiere, I just came to find out that it's a nightmare. That Adobe Premiere really sucks. The main thing that sucks about Adobe Premiere is that it's a membership only. You can't buy the software. You have to pay the $60 a month to have the software, which it seemed okay because, you know, me, like most people, I was a part of the sheep and just walking into the slaughterhouse. And that made me realize that it's the stupidest thing ever, that your only option is membership. That's it. You can't purchase the software. There's no other way. You just have to pay the membership, which is stupid, but you don't think about it because, you know, I'm like everyone else, like a part of the sheep, you know, just walking into the slaughterhouse. So from all of this mess, I've been looking at other alternatives, and then it got me to look into DaVinci Resolve 15, which is a phenomenal software. I played with DaVinci a couple of years ago, a few years ago, when I think it was DaVinci 12, DaVinci Resolve 12. It was an okay software. I mean, the color grading, obviously most Hollywood movies are color graded with DaVinci Resolve. It's a phenomenal part of the software. But that was all about it, just the color grading. But now, after all this mess that I had with Adobe, it kind of got me into looking into a DaVinci Resolve 15, and I was just blown away by how much that the software evolved. So yeah, downloaded it and started working on it, and I was just blown away. Honestly, I was blown away. Phenomenal software. Now, if you're not familiar with DaVinci Resolve, it's a software that I think most Hollywood movies are at least color graded with, if not, you know, edited with. But it's a heavyweight software. It's not an amateur software. But before I go into depth about DaVinci Resolve, I want to talk about Adobe Premiere. Back in the day, it was the only game in town. Adobe Premiere was the best thing out there. But then I didn't use Adobe, or I wasn't editing for quite a few years. And then when I got back into Adobe, it was a membership. Okay, so for $60, you get the whole suite of you know, Adobe Premiere, After Effects, Audition, the audio, Photoshop, all of it, the whole suite for $60 a month. And I don't know why, but you know, when that's the only option you have, it seems okay, or you don't think about it. You're like, $60 a month, fine, I'll pay for it because I need it and I need to work with it. But now, my dear friends, my dear filmmakers, my dear editors, now it's different because there's a new monster in town, and that's DaVinci Resolve 15. This software, I'm telling you, if take a look at the UI, it's so sexy and so amazing and so powerful. And guess how much DaVinci Resolve 15 costs? Wild guess. Well, if you don't know it by now, it's free, okay? There is the pro version for $300, for $299 to be exact. But the difference between the pro version and the free version are slim to none. Pretty soon I'm gonna purchase the pro version. And it's not only for the extras that come with the pro version, but most importantly, it's because I want to support Blackmagic. Okay, Blackmagic Design, those are the company that owns DaVinci Resolve 15. And it's just mind-blowing that they, you know, give that software for free. Now, if you're familiar with DaVinci Resolve or Blackmagic Design, you're probably aware of Fusion. It's like the After Effects software of Blackmagic. And back in the day, it also was, I think, like a $1,500 software. It was a pricey software, the Fusion, the special effects one. And now Blackmagic just put it together with DaVinci Resolve, which means you have that for free as well. It's just mind-boggling. So it's like having the whole Adobe suite for filmmakers for free. That's how it is. And you know what? Now as I'm learning Fusion, it's even better than Adobe. So yeah, where have I been for the last few weeks? What was it, 3 weeks since I uploaded my last video? I spent a lot of time learning DaVinci Resolve. Now the editing part of it is not that difficult coming from Adobe Premiere. Not that big of a difference. The learning curve is not that steep. But when it comes to Fusion, the special effects part of it, for me, it's like learning a new language. The learning curve is steep. Nodes. I still can't fully wrap my head around nodes, but I'm getting the hang of it. You know what professional editors describe it as? Like Lego blocks compared to layers. So yeah, it's different. It's very different. But yeah, I'm putting some time into learning Fusion. Fairlight, the audio part of DaVinci, also freaking amazing. It's just unbelievable that you get such a powerful software for free. Just unbelievable. And then color grading, which is, that's what, you know, put DaVinci out there. I think like 95%+ of all TV shows and movies are color graded with DaVinci Resolve. That's how powerful the color grading in DaVinci Resolve is. I'm talking major Hollywood movies color grade with DaVinci Resolve. Think about it. With Adobe Premiere, your only option is to rent membership. That's it. You can't purchase the software. And the more I researched for other options, the more I found people that are so frustrated with Adobe Premiere. Now, on top of that, you always have to be online. So if you're traveling and you don't have internet connection, even though you're paying the membership, you can't use it. You're offline, forget about it. No Adobe Premiere, no Adobe Suite, nothing. Can't use it. Also, when I started having problems and I researched and I went into forums and YouTube and whatnot, I only came to find that I wasn't the only one that's so frustrated with Adobe, that it's so buggy, it crashes constantly. It's not a stable software, and it's something that you have to pay monthly for. And if you don't have internet connection, you can't use it. And it's a buggy software. All of a sudden a light bulb just went off and I was like, what the hell is this? Seriously, what the hell is this? Your only option is membership, really? The only option is I can rent that software? The only thing I can think of is greed, is how Adobe became greedy for money. when that's the only option to rent the software, it's just disgusting. But now that there is a new monster in town, DaVinci Resolve 15, and I'm serious, it's a monster of a software. The hell with Adobe Premiere. I'm just so done with them, never using them. Canceled my membership. The only thing that I feel it's gonna kind of like be a bummer is losing Photoshop, even though they have the photographers membership plan for Photoshop and Lightroom for, I think it's $10 a month. Maybe I'll do that. But yeah, when it comes to editing, so here's the thing, on YouTube there aren't that many tutorials of DaVinci Resolve online. There are a few, but it's not that mainstream like Premiere. Like, I remember every time I needed to look up something for Premiere Pro, tons of videos on YouTube where I could learn or whatnot. With DaVinci Resolve, you will find some tutorials or some professional editors that do vlog or give tutorials online, but not that many. But here's the thing, and this is what really made me fall in love with DaVinci Resolve. Blackmagic Design, on their website, they have phenomenal tutorials, like high grade tutorials. So if you're using Adobe Premiere, I highly recommend you dump them and grab DaVinci. Get to know that software, learn it. It's worth the time and the effort to learn it. Now again, the editing part of DaVinci Resolve is not that difficult, okay? Especially if you're coming from Adobe Premiere or any other editing software, the learning curve is not that steep when it comes to editing on DaVinci. But the rest, especially Fusion, the special effects part of it is, for me anyways, is really hard. It's literally like learning a new language. But I see the power in that, and the things I'll be able to do with it once I'll be proficient in it is just the sky's the limit. And I'm looking forward to that, and that's why it's worth it for me every time. A few hours before work, a few hours after work, learning the DaVinci. So yeah, go ahead and do that. Seriously, dump Adobe, grab DaVinci, and you really, not only you won't regret it, you'll be saving a lot of money. If you do like DaVinci Resolve, and if you, especially if you're a professional and you're starting to work with DaVinci Resolve, I also highly recommend to purchase the pro version, the $300 version, mainly to support Blackmagic, mainly for how wonderful they are that they give us such a powerful tool for free. I don't know, I'm a fan, I really am. So I encourage like people to also vote with their wallets. Like if it's something that you're going to start doing, or you are doing, maybe you're working with DaVinci on the free software. Even though there isn't much of a difference between the free version and the pro version, I highly recommend purchasing the pro version, again, for the support. You know, let's vote with our wallets and show them how much we appreciate that freaking phenomenal, amazing, beautiful, gorgeous, sexy software. As I started searching online for solutions with the problems that I had with Adobe, I just ran into so many filmmakers who are frustrated with Adobe, and so many of them jumped ship with Adobe. Check out what some filmmakers say about Adobe Premiere on YouTube.
So why did I abandon Adobe Premiere? There was actually various reasons, but I would say the main one is really their subscription model, you know, service thing.
Why I switched from Adobe Premiere to DaVinci Resolve Studio.
Since about 2016, I've had consistent problems with crashing, media issues, playback, just countless errors that have gotten worse and worse over time. And that's the biggest disappointment. For something that you pay for monthly, you would expect that each month the software would get better and better and better. But unfortunately, that has not been the case with Adobe Premiere Pro at all. And that's when I knew that I had to leave Adobe Premiere Pro. It is so unoptimized that I can't do my job.
I am jumping ship from Adobe Premiere Pro to DaVinci Resolve Studio 14.
DaVinci Resolve. Anyways, guys, that's my take on it. DaVinci Resolve all the way. Adobe Premiere, bye-bye, never again. If you are using Adobe Premiere, I highly recommend you dump them. Go grab DaVinci Resolve, and I promise you, you will not regret it. So my video upload consistency is not going to be as I planned it to be, once a week. And that's because I really want to dive into DaVinci and spend most of the free time that I have getting to know that software, like, inside out, like, especially Fusion, the special effects part of it. But I'll still be uploading videos, of course, but I just don't know how often. It still might be once a week. Like I said, the editing part of the software is, I got it, it's easy. But I want to know more, so I want to spend more time on that. So yeah, I hope that it helped you a little bit. Don't forget, the links are down below for Blackmagic Design, DaVinci Resolve's website, and also the tutorials for DaVinci. All right, my peeps, that's all I got. Hopefully it helped you. If you're into filmmaking, video editing, hopefully it helped you make the decision of dumping Adobe, grabbing DaVinci. And I guarantee you won't regret it. But that's all I got. Thank you for watching. Thank you for sticking around. And stay tuned for my next videos. Peace out, y'all. Love y'all.